Hello, Spinner, you're on Penstock channel about pen spinning. My name is Alex Lanz, and tonight we will copy an interesting combo from Kush, Indian pen spinner with an impressive and interesting style. And under my previous video where I copied a Noel's combo, there were sarcastic comments such as, "Whoa, almost the same, almost the second Noel. Noel is the second Alex." But seriously, I don't copy style, just trick sequences. That's it. What's the point of copying the whole style of a pen spinner when you want to borrow some links? You have your own way of doing different elements, come on. Anyway, I like to add some wiper combos in my mini combo library, and this one I liked. Yeah, wipers with some aerial elements, a good way to spice up our freestyles and combos. I'm not going to make a full breakdown of the full whole combo, we will focus on this particular part. Yeah, I like this combo, by the way. What did you make it for?
It was for battle against Skildo.
Those were two most interesting combos from India, from you and from Skildo. And yeah, I asked Kush to help to break down this mini combo, because who can explain it better than author? First hand. And of course to make sure that I repeat it right, without any inaccuracy. Due to filming angle, you know, however good shooting angle is, it can show all elements equally clear. Did you get these moves from somewhere, or do you made them up by yourself?
You know, PSO 20 Vipers, it was from one of the combos. I'm not that experienced to make original stuff on my own. So I mostly copy link, but I make original stuff is.
Since Kush was here online, I wanted to know a bit more about fellow pen spinner and decided to ask a couple more questions before we jump into breaking down the combo. And well, spinners, I'm not accustomed to ask questions and do such like an interview videos. Sometimes I will sound a bit ridiculous, but you have to give me some credit, and maybe next time I will sound less like...
Do you understand life? Do you?
When did you start pen spinning?
October 2019. Actually, I knew the basics in like 2016. Only I knew the thumb round and charge, but then I left pen spinning. I didn't actually research in depth. Then, you know, lockdown and stuff. So I got more interested and I saw combos on internet and yeah, that's how I started.
Do you have some preferred pen mod?
Yeah, this... this one is Flower V4. Yeah, and this one is my personal. The grips and tips are from a factory made mod and Miffy and Melanin body, right? And it's pretty good for wipers.
And do you practice wipers often?
Yeah, actually I've taken wipers as my forte, so yeah, I do practice it a lot.
So you are one of those wiper style pen spinners?
Yeah, and my aim is to actually win PSO 22 in wipers.
Wiper style is pretty cool. Kush shared some wipers combo he looks after, and I suggest you watch some of them as well, they are really nice. Okay, let's get right into today's combo. If you want to check the whole conversation, it is available for those guys who support me and Penstock for channel members. Do you remember this combo which you did?
Yeah, I was practicing actually.
It goes like this, this is confusing part.
Yeah, the C6. And you do a cardioid.
The first part. Is this right? So...
Yeah. Yes. It's right.
Okay.
Yep. Yeah. Like this.
We do this grip charge reverse in 1-2 and let pen mod go under 2. Why did you cross fingers though?
It looks cool actually.
Because of aesthetic, right?
I could get more points due to that.
Waves from fell to frame and from
ghost PS.
First I learned how to get to this position, it wasn't that difficult. When grip gets under 2, I move thumb closer. At first grip is between 2 and thumb, and then I slip 2 off the grip. After that I tossed pen from this position to get better understanding of how much force I should apply to it, to let it make half turn in the air and land in 2-3. Just sway pen and release it from T3. Like, if at least once you get a good old slap in the face while doing this aerial element. And that's why you should be careful, don't use your ridiculous strength. A slight toss is enough. Now start with this charge motion in T3, this way it will be easier to then continue with doing Sonic 2312. Because that's gonna be one of those connecting fillers before the next interesting element. It will demand some practicing, but you get rewarded with a smoother execution, and further elements will go easier when you give your pen mod such a rollout. After wiper release, we catch pen mod in 2-3 and do Sonic 2-3-1-2 very very close to a cap, so the combo will still look kinda wipery. Warped Sonic 1-2-2-3, then pass 2-3-1-2, and we get almost at the same position as the beginning. Why is it almost the same? It is completely the same position. Okay, right from this moment I caught myself into this thinking what the hell I was getting into. Looks pretty hard, doesn't it? But quickly I realized that it looks much harder than it really is, which as always makes this element quite awesome and totally deserves being mastered.
It's like Haitua from a Viper.
No, it's called cardioid.
This?
This thing is called cardioid. It's called back cardioid actually. The cardioid, which is this one, is thumb around cardioid, and this is 2-3-4 cardioid. So it goes like this.
I looked at this element more of like Haitua starting from Viper, especially when Kush performs it with a raised pinky. But from the second look, I think that Kush is right. So this reversed cardioid looks hard, but in fact it's not. It's easier than the first part. First, practice to do this hand bust from 1-2. Give your pen momentum by swaying hand and then release it from 1-2. Let pen turn overhand and land it in 1-2 again. Then practice starting from the same as in the beginning, charge reverse, gripped charge reverse 1-2. Most often raising 4 helps to make pen turn overhand, but whenever I try to learn Haitua or hand bust or this cardioid, by raising pinky, I made pen's movement a bit more unpredictable. So check by yourself which way to learn. As for my way of doing it, I move fingers closer to each other, so when pen turns, most of its weight is out.
So you also told me about this pen spinning board. You guys have a community on Discord. It is only for Indian pen spinners, right?
No, actually.
On Hindi.
No, it's not Hindi. Everyone can join.
And you are about to come up with a collaboration video, right?
15th August is Independence Day of India.
So it is a date based.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for your explanation for this combo.
Sure.
I will leave link to Indian pen spinning board in description under this video. If you like this video, let me know about that and check out other intermediate and beginner combos by following the links in the description. You can find them in suitable playlists.